the center of our great public. It's to discuss an issue at the center of our efforts to build back better from the coronavirus pandemic. And I'm speaking of investments in passenger rail, or rather the lack thereof of investment in far too many communities across Massachusetts and across the nation. It's a shame that Massachusetts, the birthplace of President John Quincy Adams, the first president to ride on a train, is still fighting for its own rails across the country. Passenger rail is an essential ingredient for our healthy economy, a healthy environment, and a healthy workplace. Studies consistently show that expanding passenger rail improves mobility, enhances safety, promotes economic development, generates new jobs, and protects the environment all at the same time. Yet despite these clear benefits, Congress has not dedicated the resources required to build a passenger rail network worthy of the 21st century. And that's why President Biden's American Jobs Plan rightfully calls for $80 billion in new funding for rail. And these investments, divided amongst enhancing Amtrak, promoting railway safety, and creating new passenger lines in Massachusetts and in the country. And I believe that President Biden and his proposal is an essential starting point. But as we now flesh out the details and put together a comprehensive infrastructure package, we must ensure that we are building a rail system that works for all Americans. These investments cannot just go to connecting the megacities. We need passenger rail service for our gateway cities as well. And a network that serves the needs of all the smaller communities as well. They're often left behind in a modern world. And that's why today we're proud to announce the reintroduction of legislation to expand passenger rail service across Massachusetts, the North Atlantic region, and the entire United States. Our bill for building rail across intercity networks to ride around interior of the nation, or the Brain Train Act, will authorize $5 billion per year for a total of $25 billion for 5 years to support high-performance passenger rail networks that offer service to unconnected and underconnected communities. Massachusetts isn't just the Bay State, we're the Brain State. We are home to one of the greatest innovation economies in the world, and we need a brain train that connects every part of Massachusetts to the businesses, workers, and opportunities that make up our world-renowned regional innovation economy. The Brain Train Act is specifically designed with several Massachusetts projects in mind, including East-West Rail, South Coast Rail, a Berkshire's Housatonic line, and the North-South Rail Link. And I'm confident that each of these projects would benefit from the federal funding that our legislation will make available, and that the Brain Train Act will create a new connection between Boston to Pittsfield, with connections in Worcester and Springfield along the way. Boston to New Bedford, the Fall River, and the Berkshires to New York City. But beyond that, the Brain Train Act and the American Jobs Plan would provide enough funding for us to develop a bigger vision of passenger rail. It's about east, west, and all of the rest. With sufficient resources, we can ensure that central and western Massachusetts are at the hub of a new regional rail network instead of just picking up the caboose. Cities like Worcester and Springfield will be the crossroads for all of the activity that will arise when we connect our information economy to every part of the East. And Worcester is growing by the day in Massachusetts and the Western Massachusetts Rail Coalition, as well as national groups like the Rural and Natural Resources Defense Council, Transportation for America, and the Rail Passenger Association. And I'm committed to working with these organizations to make the brain drain path the law. Now is the perfect time for us to fight too, because Congress is debating the American jobs and the brain drain fits squarely within President Biden's infrastructure effort. The legislation specifically provides the focus and the funding that will ensure small and historically disadvantaged communities that they have the good connections into the larger national rail network that we plan to create. And in order to make sure we build a truly transformational system, we will be fighting to go even bigger and bolder than the president's initial proposal. After all, every $1 invested in public transportation generates $4 in economic returns. And every $1 million invested in public transportation supports and creates more than 15,000 jobs. And that means funding Texas and Rail is one of the smartest choices that we can make in this economic recovery. The Brain Drain Act and the American Jobs Plan will strengthen our workforce, help tackle the climate crisis, and contribute to a more equitable future for all Americans. It is essential that we get this done. This is our moment in history. We are back to 1933. This is our ability to plan for the future as we need investments in economic growth. Nothing. This whole concept of a dream that links small communities in Massachusetts and ultimately the world together as a web of technology. So let me now turn and recognize a great leader from Worcester, but the whole country.
Well, first of all, thank you, Ed, for your leadership and being here today to make this announcement. And I will be the proud official of this legislation. And I look forward to working with you to get me enacted, to get me much more incorporated in our infrastructure bill as possible. I want to thank Chris and Karen and Ben for being here. Appreciate your leadership on these issues as well. And I appreciate the fact that they have been consistent in their call for a 21st century infrastructure network. You know, in so many ways, we're more connected than ever. But it may shock some people to learn that just getting from central Massachusetts, let alone western Massachusetts, to Boston can be an endeavor. People in communities like Worcester have known this for a long time. People here in our local Commonwealth have been calling for change. But the reality is that for decades, America has not invested in our infrastructure the way we should. Now we have what would be a once-in-a-generation chance to make it happen. The stars have aligned in Portland, Washington in a way that I haven't seen since I first arrived. We have a president who is calling on us to move along. We have a Congress that is actually in touch with public opinion on infrastructure, climate change, and on building an inclusive economy. We have a real opportunity to break through the noise and through the gridlock and transform our communities. But we need to get it right. We need to build a national rail network that doesn't leave any community behind. One that empowers smaller communities to have a say in shaping the future of our country. Going big and bold of passenger rail and on infrastructure in general is about having the creativity and courage to see the problems we face as interrelated and the solutions we seek as comprehensive. That's why, that's what makes ideas like the East-West Rail so promising and so important. We can expand economic opportunities across the state while cutting emissions and addressing issues of affordability and access. All of this comes down to this. It's about vision. It's about having the vision to see the Northeast as not just a corridor, but a constellation of communities
Understood the power of rail to help revitalize
Today, regular train service from Boston ends in Houston. There's no reason it has to. It should continue on to Palmer and to Springfield and to Pittsfield and to Great Barrington and Albany. We need those connections. Those communities deserve those connections. My grandfather grew up in Munson, Massachusetts, and in the 1930s, he could take a one-seat train ride to Montreal or to London, or transfer to Palmer and take a two-seat ride to Boston, Albany, or New York City. We had those connections in the past, and there is no reason why communities like Munson and Palmer cannot have those connections again. That's what the Brain Train Act does. It supports reconnecting communities like that with high-quality rail service. Transportation is the largest source of greenhouse gases in any sector of the Massachusetts economy. And pre-pandemic, those emissions were rising, even while emissions in other sectors of the Massachusetts economy were falling. That's in part because, even though our vehicles are getting more efficient, we have Senator Markey to thank for being a leader on that for many decades, we're doing a lot more driving in Massachusetts. We drive about 50% more today than we did in 1990. So that air pollution and the greenhouse gases are a result of that. And what that tells us is that we can't just rely on efficiency and electrification. We need to be reducing the amount that we drive, and we can only do that by giving people good options. The Brain Train Act will help with that. The Transportation for Massachusetts Coalition is proud to endorse this legislation and to work with Senator Markey, Congressman McGovern, and the rest of the Massachusetts delegation to make this bill a reality. Thank you for being here today, and thanks especially to our leaders in Congress for making this act possible and for making it a reality in the future. Thank you.
Yeah, so I guess I'm wondering just how this kind of fits into, I know the state has been planning for this east to west rail between Springfield, even Pittsfield, all the way to Boston. So is this going to kind of be branching off this original plan that's been in the works for so long now?
Well, this fits into that plan. The goal is to see an expanded rail system. Change in Quincy on Monday, and Quincy's population has gone up 10,000 to 15,000 people in the last 2 years. They have 4 tea stops, and much of the development is around those tea stops. In other words, transportation, the people's accessibility to it. Same thing is true from all the way to tea stops. And we're seeing tremendous growth because of it. Well, the same thing is true on here. If we build it, they will come. They will use these systems. Houses will be built there. But we will have new economic investment to build. But you have to look to the future. You have to plan in a way that captures this incredible economic opportunity, which we are seeing in the way in which we all around the country, all around the world, are viewing Massachusetts right now. From my perspective, it includes each of those communities. Question?
Actually, this one may be good for Congressman Govern. I know everyone has been waiting and waiting, and most people obviously are in favor of this. Where do we go from here with the Brain Train Act in terms of getting it passed and like getting a time frame set?
So we need to, my view, we need to get this done, or as much to be done in the next 2 years as possible. As I said, the stars are aligned. I hope they're aligned for the next 100 years, but we know they're aligned for the next 2 years, so we need to focus on moving this forward. We need to make sure that whatever infrastructure package goes forward includes as much of this bill and as much funding as possible. Again, we can talk about plans all we want, but unless we provide the resources and the funding, they're going to just remain plans. People in Central Massachusetts, in my representative, and
that these were incredibly great cities that have played a key role in Massachusetts history, economically and socially. And if we have they will continue to not only participate, but to be leading in that effort. So actually, there's a lot of people that would like to take a convenient trip out to see the root songs, you know, to be able to just go home and have a good day, and to be able to say, I had a great night in Worcester. And if we do it right, the same thing would be true for Springfield, Pittsfield, other parts of the world. But we have to envision the
yes, Senator, I completely agree. I mean, I think the proof is in the pudding with what we see in terms of development located around this station. After this event is done, I'm going to walk down to the Canal District. I'm going to have lunch at the Worcester Market, which is going to be thriving because of its transportation. And this is not one thing for Worcester, the cost of the coast. Worcester exists because it's at a transportation crossroads in the same way it's Springfield does. It's always been connected by canals first and then rail after that. It's helped what make this city so great over centuries. We're seeing rail play a part in Worcester's revival, and the more connections that cities like Worcester have to other places where people want to be or want to work, the more valuable that will be. That's the nature of networks. The more destinations you have in that network, the more you want to use them. And that's what's in the market.
Yes, we need